Hello and welcome to High Voltages. Most of the RFID tutorials on internet will teach you how to read RFID card and that read once only. For example, it will not tell you when the card is removed. Like in RFID based attendance system, we do not need to know when card is removed. But for some cases, you need to read RFID tag continuously and you must know that tag is present or removed in order to trigger different things. For instance, in Six Candles game, you need to read card continuously. In this video, we are going to write a code that will tell us if the card is placed on a reader or removed. If you are interested in building RFID based attendance system, consider watching my detailed tutorial with code by clicking the link in the description. Also, the code for this video will be in description along with the detailed tutorial. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by Windsource Electronics. Windsource Electronics is a wholesale distributor of board level electronic components. They are always consistent since 1999, dedicated to assisting their customers to quickly and accurately find obsolete, end-of-life, hard-to-find parts and acquire authentic common used parts at competitive price. I have mentioned the link to the website. Please check that. Let me introduce the components we will need. Arduino UNO, MFRC522 RFID reader, RFID tags, solderless breadboard, jumper wires, and LEDs. Now let's build a circuit. We will use breadboard to connect RFID module with Arduino, because then it will be easy for us to make connections. Meanwhile, I am making connections, let me give you a short introduction of RFID. RFID stands for Radio Frequency Identification, and MFRC522 reader which we are using in this project used for contactless communication at a frequency of 13.56 MHz. The reading range of this module is approx 3 cm. If you are looking for a greater range, you can consider using other RFID modules with a greater range. You can also increase the range by using the active tags, which contains batteries. We are using passive tags, which is powered by the reader, and we cannot read active tags by this reader. MFRC522 is connected to Arduino using SPI communication, which is like other communication means such as I2C or UART. SPI or Serial Peripheral Interface is interface commonly used to send data between microcontrollers and small peripherals such as shift registers, sensors and SD cards. It is asynchronous communication. We will connect SDA or serial data pin to D10. SCK or serial clock pin to D13. MOSI or master out serial in to D11. MISO or master in serial out to D12. Ground to ground. And this module is powered by 3.3 volt. So to power it up, we will connect VCC or 3.3 volt to Arduino's 3.3 volt and reset pin to D9. Now we will connect LEDs to indicate that card is present or removed. Green LED will be on for the time card is present on tag, and when it is removed, LED will be turned off. Connect negative of LEDs to Arduino ground. And positive of green LED to D7. And positive of red LED to D6. Now, let's connect Arduino to laptop using USB cable. We will first import these two libraries. If you do not have MFRC522 library, you can go to Sketch, Include Libraries, and then in Library Manager. There you can find MFRC522 and install it. After defining the libraries, you will have to add few variables. You have to define reset pin, SS pin, which is our SDA pin, and LED pin, which we are using. After that, we will create the MFRC522 instance by using the reset and SS pin. Then we will write a void setup function. In this setup function, we will first declare the LED pin as output. And then we will initiate serial communication by defining the baud rate so we can see the serial values. And then we will initiate SPI communication and MFRC. After setup function, we will add few more variables for storing the RFID tag values and flags to check if card is present or not. Then we will add two functions, printhex and cpid. Printhex is for printing the tag values in hexadecimal, and cpid function is for copying the ID of the tag. After this, we will write a void loop function. In the loop function, we will first create an object of MIFARE key, and then by reading the status of RFID, by reading the status code, it is returning. Then we will add two conditions to check if there is new card present or not. If there is no new card and there is nothing on serial, we will return. That means it will not read the downward code if card is not present. If card is present, both conditions will be false, and then we will set the flag result to true. Print the new card on serial monitor with its hex value. After that, we will add a while loop in which first we will set the LED to high, and then we will continuously check for the card status, and while the card will be on reader, it will set the control flag to 13 or 14. As soon as card is removed, there will be no value on serial and control flag values will be changed, and we will get out of loop. After getting out of loop, we will turn off the LED and print card removed on serial monitor, and then halt and stop the crypto. Let's upload the code and see the results on serial monitor first. You can observe that as soon as I am keeping the card in front of reader, it is showing the tag value, and when I am removing it, it is showing card removed. Now let me show you the results on LED. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe for more such videos.